You have always been a wealth creation man. So I know Raju bhai for the last, I think, 20 years.
Yeah, almost 15, yeah. 16, so 17.
Both of us have got a common customer. And that guy is one of the most toughest customers. He's a Punjabi customer. And his every dialogue is interlaced with a lot of flowery language over there. So if you don't get the money, he'll abuse you. If you don't get this, but he always pays on time.
Yeah, yeah.
That's one of his greatest things. And Raju bhai has invested and he's got a fantastic return also, yeah, right from 20 years back over there. And he's still got you over there. Okay, so Raju bhai, where did you work before this, before you started your business?
Okay, I come from a what to say, business family. So we had own factories and iron and steel business. Then I worked for myself in an export firm, and then I have started this. So.
Okay, so what were you doing in the export?
Export, I was working as a sourcing person. So we. That firm was purely into exports of auto parts.
Hmm.
So all other things like food grains and all those things,
okay,
many things, means rubber things and all,
okay,
which
okay,
needed to be sourced. So
okay,
I was the person who used to do all the sourcing, different products and all those things. So
I didn't know that part of you. See, all the gems come out over there. So what was one learning you got from that? Being a family business, what did you learn from that?
I am here because of the family business, because in family business, yes, you get to learn how to tackle those ups and downs in the businesses. That is the key learning, that you are toughened enough.
Okay, so tell us about Arthashastra. I think I pronounced your name Arthashastra.
Arthashastra.
And why the name?
Okay, Arthashastra. I started my this financial journey in 1999. And from 99, I was an individual. From 2004, we three of us met and we started Arthashastra. Arthashastra basically has derived from, we all know Chandragupta Maurya was one of the most prosperous kings. But he was not the king, he was made king by Chanakya. Chanakya wrote various nitis, and I think half a chapter or one chapter is towards Artha nitis.
Okay.
So, nitis, all those nitis were nothing but strategies for how a king should be.
Hmm.
So we also treat our customers as kings. And draw various strategies which A, make him wealthy, and B, maintain that prosperity.
You get queen also in that.
Yeah, we get queens also in that.
Fine. So what is the right time to invest? You know, everyone says, you know, you should invest in the age of 24. There are a lot of kids over here who are earning a lot of money, spending their money. Then there are a lot of fathers paying for those kids also over there. So, and then they have no time to invest over there. Like maybe 20 years back, there was nothing about financial investment happening over there. And everybody used to believe only in fixed deposits. But nobody took into account the horrible inflation which happens over there. Where your fixed deposits have, like, you know, 10,000 about 20 years back was a big amount of money. Today's maybe one day's food bill you pay over there.
Yeah.
And hope maybe it may be your petrol bill also. That's also possible over there with the way the things are going. So what is the right time to invest in mutual funds?
Oh, there's actually mutual fund is not the only thing that you should invest in, first thing. Right time to invest is as early as possible. Means it should be yesterday. Okay.
Okay.
Practically, the thing is that you need to look at the investing has to be goal based rather than where and what to invest.
Okay.
So investing should be completely aligned to your goals. So suppose you want to plan for your child's education, or you want to plan for your retirement, or you want to plan for your yearly vacations. All those things can be planned, and the investments have to be aligned to those goals rather than buying a mutual fund or a fixed deposit. All those things are derived, the products are derived from your goals. Why it's not vice versa.
Okay. So you say about 25 should be the right time when the kid starts earning or something, or let him spend some money for 1 year and then let
I think the earlier you start, the lesser you need. Means if you start at 24-25, you can take care of your retirement at even at 10,000 rupees a year, a month, I would say. If you delay it by 5 years, I think you would require more than 30,000 for the same type of goal.
Okay.
So every 5 years block,
it increases.
The amount triples of more. It goes more than that. So.
Okay. So what are the investments? Is it only mutual funds, like you said, or are there other ways of investing also?
Investing is all about asset allocation. It's nothing to do with mutual funds. And typically mutual funds also are not only equity mutual funds.
Okay.
In mutual funds, typically you can also invest in, after equities, you can also invest in debt, which is as good as a fixed deposit or gold. And now with REITs coming in, you will be also able to invest in real estate.
Real estate, okay.
Yeah, so it will be minimum 2 lakhs kind of a unit. Okay. Okay. But you will be able to invest in real estate also through mutual funds. So mutual fund is a vehicle.
Okay.
It's not a product kind of a thing.
Okay, right. So does buying a money back LIC policy qualifies investment? I think all of us have been sold a LIC policy in our life, and at the end of the day we think, you know, why did I buy that policy? Like, I got swindled, you know. I said after 20 years I'll pay for my child's education. So you not get that now. When you die, you'll do. So I said, you want to kill myself and then I can get education over there. So a lot of people have been missold LIC policies as well as the other policies which are there. So do you think LIC policy is a investment?
Practically LIC is not an investment.
Okay.
First thing. Second thing, nothing is per se good or bad.
Okay.
What you need, that you need to define. Now 20 years back, everybody would have bought LICs and had good experiences. Means our parents, or I would say so many people I know have bought in LIC and they are good enough. But in today's time, the you cannot invest in LICs because, you know, typically the inflation has changed.
Okay.
I'll just take 1 minute to just explain it. You know, 20 years back, we all would vouch for it that the inflation was just not there. I did not see for five years real estate prices going up. I could see food grains prices were also similar. Today's time, I think every month the expenses go up.
Absolutely.
Okay. And the inflation is not only the price of things that we buy, but more of a, what to say, lifestyle inflation is kicked in quite a bit.
Very true.
So in aspirational inflation is much beyond what a person can actually imagine. It's I think 20 years back we all had one phone in our house, 25 years back. Today we buy a phone of 1 lakh rupees. It's typically true. So that's the aspirational inflation which you need to take care of.
Okay, so what are the top 3 things any person should have for securing himself?
For securing himself, I think first thing he needs to take care of is the fundamentals of investments are, you take care of your insurance, life insurance.
Okay.
Then you take care of your health insurance.
Mediclaim.
Mediclaim. And you should, you need a lots of mediclaim today. And third thing is the investments.
Okay. All three.
So all three, but in that chronological order, because if you have not taken care of your insurance, then your family is going to suffer. If you have not taken care of the mediclaim, means the cost of medical expenses have gone through the roofs. Means last 6 months I have seen in our clientele only, I think 3 or more bills exceeding 27 lakhs. Means one bill was as good as 37 lakhs. So medical expenses are going through the roof. A, either you plan for it, or you
plan for your medical emergency. So plan
means you, we do SIPs and all those things, but you plan for those things and you take care of those things, or you need to have good amount of medical insurance. And those are facts today, wherever, whatever people say, but these are things which you cannot avoid.
Okay. What is your current client portfolio like?
So we typically cater to all types of clients. Means majorly clients are middle and top management people who are working, who are professionals, and SMEs who are business owners, small business owners, and typically people who don't have time to look into their finances. And this thing, this business has moved from simple product selling to an advisory. So it's more of an advisory based. So there are good amount of clients that we have. So our key strength is that we rarely lose a client. So we don't have too many clients.
Okay.
But I started since 99. My 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 number of clients are still there. So earliest clients are there with us. So that's the strength. So it's not that we have been doing fantastically well or we have been outperforming the markets, but we have been transparent. So whatever.
So a couple of years back, you know, mutual fund industry was regulated. So a lot of people used to get kickbacks from the mutual fund companies used to give a lot of kickbacks over there. So, you know, there's good parties and all stuff and all. Actually, I was affected that way. one of our sponsors was there, who was giving us a lot of, you know, sponsorship. Suddenly on April 1st, I think 5 years back or something, they passed this, you cannot do any more.
2010.
You cannot do any more, you know, that kind of below the table activity over there to promote. Not below, it was above the
table. It was not below the table, it was, there was an upfront, means commission was given, which is reduced drastically.
Drastically. So that affected a lot of people, I think, especially a lot of mutual fund people were affected in that.
Yeah, there were people who were just kind of qualified couriers. Kind of, I would say, who would just distribute forms and get the applications. And the business was very simple. You distribute 10,000 forms and you will get back 200 applications, and you could make good amount of money in that. But the business has transitioned from there. Today it is more advisory based. And yes, so many people who couldn't cater to that advisory were not there. But today, lot many people have come. Very good quality advisors have come into the industry today. Yes.
Okay, so I have approximately 3,500 friends currently on Facebook and 3,000 people following me on Facebook. I think out of that, at least about 200 are all financial consultants. We all, you know, we'll plan your finance and all that. So how do you compete against such people over there? What is your USP?
Okay, at Arthashastra, basically the difference is that we purely, you know, everybody over here has some companies, some business, and everybody has their company balance sheet. We only focus on personal balance sheets.
Okay.
Okay. I have known so many CFOs of the companies who are my clients.
Achha.
Okay. They could be knowing inside out about the company, it's every penny where it is there. But when it comes to personal balance sheet, people are really ignorant. And that is an area where, you know, people need to work. So we only focus on personal balance sheet and cash flow management. So personal family cash flow management is a very different thing, and that requires little bit of commitment, but it gives you immense clarity on how you should manage your money. So practically you are not never, means if you can control these two things, you can never be sold a product. So that last day, this is the best product, all those things, all those gimmicks will not come to you, because you should know what I want and what will help me in my cash flow. So that's the way, and that's why we, I think, have been surviving, it's kind of, and growing.
Surviving, thriving also.
Yeah,
both
thriving,
yeah. Okay, social media. Which social media platform you are comfortable with?
Majorly Twitter, LinkedIn, and Facebook.
And Facebook. And your WhatsApp now.
That's also become WhatsApp,
like a social media platform. So every Sunday he sends us Ravi Sutra. Sorry, sir. My Hindi is bad. So all of us look forward. So one day it doesn't come, kya ho gaya Raju bhai, tune nahi bheja hai kya? He says, I'm a bit late today.
So I can be late, but I never missed.
I'll never miss that one. You'll never miss that one. And Vimesh will ask, why is it not come over there?
No, I have never given the opportunity for that.
Achha, he's not given that one. Tell us about your family.
Yeah, my wife is a homemaker. I have a kid. He's in 10th now.
Oh, and you're here.
Yeah, but he's still...
Khatam ho
gaya.
You know, 10th and 12th, like, is like, you know, oh God.
So he takes care of himself, so nothing to worry
about. Very good, they should take care of themselves.
Yeah.
Your hobbies?
Hobbies, typically watching cricket, traveling and reading.
You also love to go for singing and that natak.
Haan, singing thoda bahut aur natak ka to hai, thoda shauk hai wo to.
Shauk hai uska. Your future, where do you see your company maybe 10 years from now? I forget 10 years, but 2 years from now.
2 years from now, I have planned to retire in 31st of December.
What about all of us? You know,
money or not? Hoga. But team will be there, Arthashastra will be there, but okay. I will be retiring by 2020.
What will you do?
Follow my passion. So this is actually my passion, but there are few other things. I want to travel a lot, so all those things are pending.
You can still travel and work also. Retire nahi hona chahiye.
Retirement, that's a very difficult question, different question. Retirement has nothing to do with work. Okay. Retirement has more to do with you stop working for your lifestyle expenses.
Okay.
Financially.
Yeah, you should be financially free. It has nothing to do with what you're working. And this is what we do for all our clients. And if I don't deliver that thing, what's the point?
Absolutely. Fantastic. Raju, thank you so much. It was useful and interesting.
Thank you.
So that's your Arthashastra Math.
Thank you.
With a nice photo of you.
Nice photo. Thank you.